Oakleaf. Yes. Those of you who haven't seen, this is your last chance. Okay. And I've written a story especially for this festival just 2 days ago. So you'll have to excuse me for reading it out. All right. So it begins this way. Kalima was a very happy-go-lucky blue oakleaf butterfly. She loved to joke and tease other insects. For her, life was all fun and play. Even as a caterpillar, she just did not want to stop eating the leaves. Her mother had to scold her, cajole her, and the other elders had to sweet-talk her until finally, reluctantly, she agreed to turn into a pupa or a chrysalis. Inside a chrysalis also, she was very impatient. She just could not wait to emerge as a butterfly and have all the fun around. Anyway, as an adult, days rolled by and it was time for Kalima to lay eggs. She began to twiddle her antennae, like all mothers-to-be butterflies do, sniffing for the right plant to lay her eggs. It had to be the kauri plant. Her caterpillars that would hatch, she knew, would eat only kauri leaves. For all butterfly caterpillars are fussy brats when it comes to eating. They are very particular about the plant whose leaves they eat. She fluttered her wings and flew to a bush her compound eyes had caught sight of. The leaves resembled those of kauri. She tasted the legs. You know with what? What do butterflies taste with? With her feet. Yuck! These tasted very, very bitter. If she couldn't quite like the taste, how were her rats to be going to like it? They certainly were not kauri leaves. Just then, she got the surprise of her life, for sitting next to her on the bush was what looked like an owl. Two deadly large eyes stared at her. Kalima felt her legs trembling, but nevertheless, she put up a bold front. Missy Owl, I don't think you like to eat butterflies, do you? There are sure to be plenty of fat, fleshy mice around. Ha ha, Miss Kalima, said the owl-like creature. I know all about your teasing ways, but today the tables have turned. It is I that have fooled you. I am not an owl, so what was it? Any guess? No, I am a harmless owl moth. An owl moth has two big eyes on its wings and it looks like an owl to frighten its predators. Well, is that so? Kalima retorted, regaining her composure. Saying this, the blue oak leaf folded her wings. I challenge you to find me, owly. Your voice is coming from that twig, but there is only a leaf there, a dry leaf. I can't see you anywhere. Kalima opened her wings to flash the brilliant azure blue on the upper side of her wings. Did you know that blue oakleaf butterflies have these two kinds of wings, upper wing and under wing? The upper wing is like this and the under wing is like this to fool the predators. Ha ha, the dry leaf was me. That's how my under wing looks. So, owly bowly, I got the last laugh. With that, Kalima took off, looking for the kauri plant that was to be her young one's nursery and singing to herself, tra-la-la-la-la-la-la. Buzz! It was a bee, her pollen baskets loaded, heading for her hive. Oh, Miss Bee, I see that you are, as always, very busy. Why don't you stop for a bit? We can have some fun together. You can do your waggle dance, and I will just sashay and swivel and flutter and flounce. Kalima flew round and round in circles while she spoke. I have my duties to perform, said Busy Bee. I have to deliver the nectar and pollen. from flowers to the beehive. Or as a queen bee will be mad with a busy bee began to feel giddy watching Kalima going round and round. "Hold it," cried Kalima as she rushed to steady the bee. But in the effort, the bee's pollen basket tipped over and the pollen fell all over Kalima. Achoo, cried Kalima. "Your pollen has covered my Antony and my taste buds. On my feet, achoo, I can't smell or taste now. How am I going to find a carvy plant? And I have to go collect pollen all over again. This is what happens when I am interrupted during my duties," the bee grumbled. Kalima was confident that sooner or later she would find the carvy for her babies to be born, though she could not smell or taste. As she flew on, she came across a black Raja butterfly. "Hi, Miss Kalima. Oh, I see that you are looking for something. Oh, did you know where I can find a curry plant for my eggs? The bee dusted me with her pollen, so I just can't smell with my Antony, nor can I taste with my feet. I am sorry, I have no clue, but I know where you can find some yummy buffalo poop down there," the black Raja informed, patting his bloated abdomen, because the Rajas like to eat not nectar but dung. "So very soft and juicy, slurp, slurp." "No thanks, Raja boy. Animal poop is not for me," was Kalima's reply. And on she flew. A little distance away, Kalima came across a gang of 30 or so Nawab butterflies, all males on a damp mud patch. They all looked very handsome to Kalima, and so she decided to stop and chat with them for a while. "Hi, what's up?" she called flirtatiously. One of the Nawabs looked at her from the corner of his compound eyes and hushed her. "Shh! Why the grim silence?" she called extra loudly. "Is this some kind of meditation camp or a hangout of druggists?" "We are mud paddling, can't you see?" said another Nawab, sipping at the mud with his proboscis as if there was no tomorrow. "You just saw in the film about mud paddling, didn't you?" "That sounds cool," said Kalima. She too shut out her proboscis and began to sip away thirstily. "Glub, glub, glub, glub. This tastes very salty. It's not all that exciting. I think you guys are wasting your time in this boring activity. Why don't you socialize with interesting females like me? That would be more fun." But the Nawabs did not pay any attention to Kalima, and so on she flew in the quest of the carvy plant, which she could not smell or taste. She hadn't flown for long when she heard loud, raucous singing. "We are the jolly good fellows, heck! We are the jolly good, heck, fellows!" "Aha, that sounded like fun! A bunch of sailor butterflies and barons had got drunk, sipping on some overripe figs and jamuns." Kalima had to stop and join in. The butterflies welcomed her with open wings. The fermented fruit punch tasted super delicious, and Kalima too started feeling tipsy. "Hick, hick," she went. Just then, another blue oakleaf butterfly landed next to the group of intoxicated butterflies. "Hi, Kalima," the other oakleaf greeted. "Did you finally get to lay your eggs?" She was so tipsy. "Thanks for reminding me. Can you tell me where I can find some curry?" "There is one just down there," she was told, "where I had laid my eggs." The other oak leaf began helping herself to the fruit punch too. "Thanks," called out Kalima as she flew tipsily In a zigzag manner, she finally reached the Karvi shrubs. But she was in for a big surprise. What was the surprise? What do you think it was? Anyone can guess? Yes?
She couldn't taste.
No, there was some other surprise. Anyone else?
She laid egg.
But before that, you know what? All that was left of the Karvi was bare stems with very many blue oak leaf pupae clinging onto them. The shrubs were completely bereft of all leaves. The leaves had been munched upon by the caterpillars of other blue oak leaf butterflies. So Kalima had sadly missed the bus. So that's the story. I want you all to think, what could she have done? Because there were no leaves now. Where would she leave her eggs? Anyone can give me a...
All the leaves.
There were no leaves. All the leaves were eaten up by the caterpillars.
On the branch.
On the stems and branches, maybe. But what do the caterpillars that were to be born eat?
If you were in another country.
Oh, she flew somewhere else. Well, that's anybody's guess. The answer is blowing in the wind. I leave you all to think about it. Thank you very much for being patient with me.
For kids, but I'm buying all of them. So we are at the